Now, dear one, the sexual energy can still be used and allowed to flow out within you, in a genuine way, in a way to uplift others within this world through sexual partnership. But it must be done first, dear ones, by coming within the heart, by staying within the heart. In order for this to happen, dear one, there is a knot, the second psychic knot of the human energy system that exists within the heart. In order to clear the psychic knot within the heart, dear ones, in order for the heart to open, the heart chakra, not the spiritual heart, dear ones, for there is a difference. In order for the heart chakra to open, the direction of the third energy center, the pursuit of selfish power over others, must be given up. It must be surrendered. It must be released. And so, dear one, once you release the desire to control another person, to take something from them through sexual interaction, through conversation, through any interaction with another as the energy flows from the lower chakra. Once you, dear ones, move out of the desire to take, you can live from the desire to give within your heart chakra. You can, dear one, then simply allow love to flow out from you and never feel depleted, never feel used, never feel that you are using. This, dear one, is the healthy expression of the sexual energy when shared with another person. But it must be done with honest communication. It must be done and can only be done once you first remove by understanding how you use this energy to manipulate the world around you, to manipulate others within your life. For you see, dear one, many of you simply engage in conversation to exchange these sexual energies. Many of you, dear ones, feel better about yourself when talking to a physically beautiful woman or man, because you get something, because you believe you are seen by others to be more accepted, to be more powerful. So you see, dear ones, the flow of sexual energy lies more than just in the bedding of our partner. It lies within how we look upon each other. It lies in how we treat one another. It lies, dear one, in how we communicate with each other, energetically and verbally. And so, dear one, it is only by coming into the state of awareness to look and see how you are currently acting, how you are currently directing the flow of the creative energy within you, that you are then able to ascend out of the behavior, that you are then able to forgive yourself, for you have grown in awareness, for you have seen the childish ways that you have created in the past, and now that you see their limitation and the suffering and separation that they cause, now, dear ones, you can forgive yourself, for you have grown in learning, and you can let it go, without guilt, without shame. You can, dear ones, understand that you were acting in a way that you thought served your highest good. But now that you have grown, you see that it did not, and so you willingly let it go. But you do not blame yourself when you act in a way that you thought was best, but now see is not. Understand, dear ones, that all humans are doing the best they can with the limited information and the influence of their past experience. Every human being is doing the best they can. Have this compassion in your heart, and have this compassion for yourself. For when you honestly accept yourself in this present moment, when you see that you have acted in the best way you thought possible, when you see this, you must be willing to accept it. You must be willing to accept that you had limited understanding within you, and that you still, dear ones, have limitation within you. It will bring you to a place of humility. It will make you humble before the vastness of the creative power of God. And it will, dear ones, allow you to let go of the limited self you are more easily. It will allow you to enter into the kingdom of heaven within, to be filled from within. But first you must release your limited self, only by seeing it, by seeing the limitation, by forgiving yourself, by understanding that you did the best that you thought possible, and then you can let it go. And so, dear ones, the next pursuit within this material world is that of food. You see, dear ones, we believe ourselves to be disconnected. We believe ourselves to be disconnected from each other, to be disconnected from the natural world, to be disconnected from God. We believe ourselves to be separate from life, and so in fear we take. In fear for survival, we take. This, dear ones, is different than the desire for power, for this is the desire for survival. It is one based on fear. It is one based on the avoidance, dear ones, of what we are afraid may come, rather than, dear ones, the pursuit of power, in which we are motivated by that which we want to become. This is avoidance, and that is seeking. So as we look, dear ones, to the avoidance of fear for survival, we often find that we act in a selfish way in order to feed ourselves, in order to earn money to pay for food, in order to take energy from others to feed our emotional body. How we take energy from others to feed the superiority of our thinking mind. How we feed upon physical food because we feel boredom, because we feel insecurity, because we feel lack. And so, dear ones, the human body requires physical food to eat as long as it is living in a limited state of existence. But there will come a place and time when humans upon this world live more fully from the light of God within, for they know everything to be a creation of consciousness. They know everything to be ultimately sustained by the Source. But, dear ones, we are not telling you to give up your physical food, but instead to look where you are at, to see how you strive and take food from others in order to fill your insecurity and belief of fear, in order to fill a void. You can look, dear ones, of how you choose and when you choose to eat. You can look at the foods you select for enjoyment, for pleasure, to avoid the pain and discomfort, to avoid the boredom of the present moment. And by choosing to no longer consume these foods at that time, you can break the chain of reinforcing and running from that which you feel within yourself. You will have to face the inner demon. You will have to face the desire and craving that seeks to avoid the uncomfortableness of being who you are, of being what is happening within this moment. You will have to face this, dear one. But you will show yourself the true strength that you have, and you will see that the fear was simply an illusion, simply a shadow that you thought was real. For when you shine your spiritual light brighter, the shadows dissolve and the truth is revealed.